Hi, my name is Kent. I'm the Creative Specialist on the Google Web Designer team, and I'd like to demonstrate fluid layout in Google Web Designer. This tutorial focuses on Flexbox anchoring and size constraints and builds on existing tutorials for responsive design and percent authoring, so check the description for links to those videos. I'll start with a simple example of a flexible CTA button with text that scales with the button size, as shown in this design spec. Starting with a new banner, at the default size, I'll zoom in to make it easier to see, and use the Element tool to draw a div, color it, apply rounded corners, and give it a name. Since I have the exact pixel size in my spec, I'll enter that. Instead of stacking the text on top, I want it to be contained within the button, so I'll use the Selection tool to double-click and step inside, and I see this reflected in the stage path. Now with the Text tool set to Normal Text, Paragraph, create the text. Change the font and size. Apply both text fitting and truncation, and adjust the minimum font size. I want my container to collapse to the text content, so in the CSS panel, uncheck both width and height. Now I can center this inside the button with Flexbox. In the Responsive panel, Flexbox tab, check Use Flexbox to set it up. A couple notes here. What's currently selected or not selected makes no difference. Flexbox is applied to the parent level element regardless, which in this case is the button div. Also, the text must be a paragraph or header element and not a span or any of these other text elements. And notice that once you check the box, you'll instantly see all your previous positioning is reset. If you want to go back, then unchecking the box won't help. You need to Command Z or undo to get those original positions. I'll reapply Flexbox, and at this point, I'll change the text color to white since I can see it now over the button. And the Flex controls to center it are Justification Center, and the important part is Cross-Axis Alignment set to center for the vertical centering that was always so problematic before Flexbox. Now here's the trick to make the text scale relative to the button size. First, I'll double the text size to 28, and now with size constraints, I'll reduce width and height to give me the desired text size for this button size. I'll use percentages so it scales, and set the max width to 60%, which I can eyeball against my spec to see I have the correct left and right margins. Now I set max height to give me the desired 14 pixel fitted text size. This takes some trial and error, but I'll jump ahead to 44%, which looks about right, and toggle the selection to confirm my fitted text size is 14 in the text panel. And now to test this, I'll step out to the root div and resize the CTA with the transform control. I see my text is resizing along with the button and constrained by both the button width and height. And a reality check at 100% stage zoom to make sure it looks good. Anytime you want resizing text to fill the available space, you do the same thing with the same structure. So with the headline, for example, the button element becomes an uncolored container holding the headline text. Now that I have my flexible CTA, let me quickly show a couple responsive cases. First, I'll make my document responsive with this checkbox in the Responsive panel, Sizes and Ranges tab. I might want to anchor this button to the bottom center of my ads, which is easy in the Properties panel, Anchoring Section, by just selecting the appropriate square. And I can still move it around while keeping it anchored. I'll nudge it up with the Shift arrow keys. Then I'll turn off the transform control to make it easier to see and test this by resizing the viewport. Notice the button size isn't changing yet. If I wanted it to, I'd first return to the starting viewport size, 300 by 250, then with the button selected and at the correct starting size, click Use Percentages in the Properties panel. And now it scales along with the ad size while remaining anchored. And you could easily set some reasonable limits to how small it gets with size constraints on the button. For example, a min height of 24 pixels, which in this case is determined by the smallest legible font size. Also noting you can mix and match units, pixels and percent, whatever makes sense for each case. And now the button and text both scale with the ad size while staying anchored to the page bottom, and never fall below a set size. Flexbox is also really good at positioning multiple elements to fill the available space, usually producing the same alignment you'd create manually as a designer. Here's a typical example. You've got a price and a crossed out old price, and you can see the position changes when the old price is shown. This used to be difficult, requiring three separate prices, special feed rules, and custom JavaScript. But now with Flexbox, it's easy and works with dynamic remarketing verticals like flights and hotels that only support two price values. I'll jump ahead to the creative in progress before adding prices. This file has a fair amount of complexity to begin with, but the Flexbox prices will be easy. This is a dynamic file created from a template which uses the swipe gallery component referencing a group item repeated for every product. To edit it, right-click the group in the library and select Edit. Double-click this container to step inside, and here's the Add Content, CTA name and image. Create a div to hold the prices and name it. And even though I want this centered, I won't use Flexbox yet because I want to leave these other elements in place. So in my Properties panel, I'll use percentages and center it numerically with 10 left, 80 width. Then edit my verticals, giving just a tiny margin, leaving most of the space available for the prices. Double-click this container with the selection tool to step inside it and create the two prices. To save time, I'll paste some styled text, but nothing fancy here, just font, size, color, and style. I'll call these price, which is always shown, and old price will be optional. For both text elements, enable text fitting and truncation, and reduce the minimum font size. Then one by one, uncheck width and height as before. And again, set size constraints and font sizes so that each scales with the ad size. Both use a max width of 100% to fill the container. Old price will use a max height of 40% and double the font size to 20. Price will get the remaining max height of 60% and double its font size to 30. In both regards, price is 50% larger than old price. Now apply Flexbox, and since we have two children this time, it's slightly more complex than the last example. First, I want to change my direction. I'll try column, which looks better, but I want the old price on top, so I could use column reverse or change the child order. Rearranging the timeline layers won't matter. You can't tell yet, but the prices are still top aligned, so to center them vertically, now I use justification center, since I've changed the direction. There's a lot of flex controls for both the parent and child elements. I won't go through them all, but check the help doc listed in the description for a detailed explanation of what each one of these settings does and how they affect each other. That's about it. So let's go back to the root div to see the results. That's okay. Let's look at some responsive sizes with the responsive preview control. And these look okay too, as I see my text is staying within the price area, not overlapping each other, and scaling with the ad size. Next is the dynamic part, which makes this work automatically. Make sure Edit Based Document is selected, Dynamic Panel and Bindings tab. Click this icon to create the new bindings. I'm using the custom schema for this example. Choose the element. Select Price, Text Content, and Bind to Price. Then add another binding with the plus icon, and I can directly select Old Price. Text Content again, and I'll use Sale Price because I know that's supported in all schemas, including custom flights and hotels. Then OK, and I just want to make sure my new sample data, Price Demo, is selected, which I've already customized for this use case. And my final test is to preview in a browser where I can see all ad sizes fully functional and confirm the prices are appearing as expected in all responsive sizes. That's it for Fluid Layout in Google Web Designer. Thanks for watching.